not satisfied. The church should be satisfied. If you're not satisfied, you can come up here this morning and you can be satisfied.
Bye.
eternity without God. The alternative is an eternity in hell. I got news for you. That's right. I'm still old-fashioned. I'm still an old-fashioned preacher. If you don't have Jesus, you're on your way to hell. But if you got Jesus, you got everything. I said if you got Jesus, you need to let the world know. You need to let them know that you have everything. You are not down. You are not forsaken. But you are bought with the price of the blood. Supposed to preach this, but I feel fired up because you know what? I am on the winning team. It's time to start acting like it. We're not on the losing team, we're on the winning team. Sister Bill, Satan has been defeated. Death has been defeated. Sin has been defeated. I have life and life for abundance. We need to get that in our soul, Chuck. Get that in our soul, Chuck. You know what? Our face will turn the other way around. You know, it takes more muscles to frown than it does to smile. But Brother Clarence, you don't know what's going on in my life. You know what? I know a lot more than you think I do. I don't know everything because I don't nosy. But I want to tell you something right now. I know what the world's going through right now. But my Bible says, when you see these things come to pass, don't put your head in the ground. Don't put your face down. But to look up, look up, look up, look up, because your redemption is coming now. He said to put your eyes on him. 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 Put your eyes on him.
It's favor. Just a little bit more pain, a little more sorrow, a little more sickness,
yes.
But not much longer. It's going to be all right.
Amen.
Because he's coming soon. And Joe, you know what the Word of God says he's coming for? Those that love him. Those that love him and are looking. Did you hear what I just said?
Yes.
Are looking for his appearing.
Yes.
They're looking for his return.
Yes.
They're looking, Sister Rosa, for his
yes.
return. Are you looking? Are you looking? Do you know why when the trumpet sounds it's not going to get you off guard if you're still here? Because you already got your eyes set on the King. Wow. You know, this is from the Holy Ghost. I didn't even have another time. My message is totally different from what this is. But God's message is most important.
Yes.
I said, do you hear what I said? The Holy Spirit said that. I'm not smart enough to think of it. Bob, you know why you're going to be ready to go when that trumpet sounds? If you know Jesus, you're serving him. Because your eyes are already on him.
That's right.
Huh? But if you're not saved, or you strayed away from him, your heart and eyes are not on him. The ones that will be left behind, there's the ones their eyes are not on Jesus. Their eyes is on the world. Their eyes on the torment. Their eyes are on the turmoil. Their eyes is on negativity, bitterness, strife, anguish. Guess what? My Bible says the fruits of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, long-suffering, goodness, mercy. Isn't that what it is? Meekness. You know what? Come on, self-control. That's what the Spirit, those fruits of the Spirit. It's not hatred. It's not envy. It's not strife. It's not bitterness. It's not gossip. It's not those things. My Bible says the fruits of the Lord are good. Into your life. You're going to look at me like I'm a crazy fool. Just give me a moment. Sherry Malone, your educator. But I'm going to tell you this right now. She can tell you right now, a student that has no self-confidence, student that comes in saying they can't learn something, most likely they're not going to learn it. Am I telling the truth? Because they've already made up their mind, they're not got the ability to do it. Is that right, Dave? If you've already made up your mind, you're not going to make it. You're already losing the battle. Did you hear what I said? God did not make you by a mistake. You're not here just to take up air. I don't care if your mother and your father don't love you, your grandma or your grandpa. I don't care. I don't know why I'm saying these things. You are loved because God so ordained that you were born into this world. Not only born, but you are born for such a time as this. The time that Jesus Christ, his turn is imminent. You have been born. You have been also, if you're saved, you have been bought with a price. You are not your own. Is that scriptural, Bob?
That's right.
Is that in the scriptures? So guess what? Sister Shirley, even when my body is ravaged in pain, I still have something to rejoice about. And I'm speaking right to you right now because I know the devil's ravaged your body in pain. But you still got something to rejoice. He can touch your body. He can do whatever he can to your body. But he can't touch your soul. He can't steal your joy. He can't steal your joy. You cannot take away what God has given you. But Lord, he can make you feel like you wish you could give up any day. But guess what? He's not only going to, the devil can only do so much. Is that correct? He can only go so far. He can only go so far. And God said, that's enough.
Amen.
Did you hear what I said?
Amen.
I said he can only go so far. And God says, that's enough. You're enough and he's enough are two different things, though. Did you hear what I said? Your enough and God's enough are two different things. Have you ever thought about, I don't know why I'm talking this. I'm just doing what God said.
Yes.
Have you ever thought like Job? Anybody suffered like Job here yet? Anybody? Come on. We've all suffered things, but anybody here suffered as bad as Job? Did Job do anything to deserve what he suffered? No. He was righteous. God said that out of his own mouth, didn't he? Didn't he tell Satan? Consider my servant Job. Didn't he ask Satan? Hey, have you considered Job? Didn't he? You know what Job means? It don't mean job. It means Job. It means persecution. That's what the word Job in Hebrew means. Persecution. He was named persecution. He was persecuted. Did he deserve it? Has anybody here been persecuted like Job? Anybody here been beaten and crucified like Christ? Did they make it? Did they make it? Oh boy, I tell you what, there's a lot of enthusiasm. I said, did they make it? On the third day, did Jesus stay in the ground? Did he?
No.
Guess what? If Christ can make it, if Job can make it before Christ ever came to the earth, if he can make it, guess what? You will too!
Amen.
If you only believe in Christ, he will not fail you. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. And lo, he is with you always, even until the end of the world.
Amen.
He's a friend that's sticking closer to your brother. He's a friend. He's a friend that comes and clings to you closer than your father or your mother. If they've forsaken you, God will not forsake you. Never been a friend like Jesus. Never been a friend like Jesus. You got Jesus as your friend this morning? I said, do you have Jesus as your friend this morning? If you don't, you can have him. Have you ever thought that God knows you're so strong? Have you ever thought, maybe, just maybe, scary, that trying student, I don't know, I'm just folding my whole pocket in here, or that trying finger, or something you got to deal with, sicknesses. Did you ever think of God actually might be saying he's proud of you when you're going through those times? Everything, oh, all things work together for good to them that love the Lord and are called according to his, let me break it down, his, not yours, his purpose.
Yeah.
faith right here. Last night I was so proud of this little young lady. I said, "What do you mean? She's not very old. I don't care." "Oh, I know. I'll make you cry. I'm sorry." This little young lady here last night was walking around with something, holding it, pushing it. And then all of a sudden, I see this little young lady walking around by herself with that, and I made her cry. I'm good about that. But she was walking around without anything. She just was walking around, and she wasn't afraid. Why was she not afraid? Mom and Daddy probably more afraid than she is. Why? Because God has put an instinct in her.
Yes.
That when she gets a certain age, she's going to start walking. And it's called faith.
Yes. Yes.
Did you hear what I said? It's called faith.
Yes.
Even in a child, God has instilled faith in a child to know that she is going to accomplish something, because it's, guess what? Her mom, her father, her sisters, whoever has instilled in her, she can do it. She can do it. She can do it. Is it adversity in learning how to walk? Oh yeah, especially when they fall and hit their head and it makes the mom and dad go, "Oh." Is it fearful? Yes. But guess God put that in. He has confidence that she's going to come through. I guarantee Rosa and Mintz believe she's going to walk one day and run and just do whatever. You got that faith, don't you, Vince?
Yeah.
You got that faith, Rosa? Why do you think God allows you to go through things? Because He has the faith and the confidence in you that you are not going to. You are not going to fail. Sister Sherry, when you give a hard test to a student you have a lot of faith in, it's not because you're trying to bring that student down, because you're trying to open the potential that's in that student. Why? Because she sees potential that's not brought out. Why do you think sometimes God allows bad things to happen to us? It's because He's trying to bring out the true potential in us. It's not because you're bad. It's not because you've done something wrong. It's because He's proud of who you are.
Amen. Amen.
You need to get a different perspective of trials sometimes.
Yes.
Why am I preaching this? I have no idea, but I am. Some of you are looking at the trial the wrong way. You're looking like it's punishment. And God says, no, it's not punishment. It's because I am proud of you, and I have faith in you, and I have confidence in you. You're not going to fail, but you're going to come out stronger.
That's right.
How you doing, Noah? How you doing, buddy? His eyes lit up when I seen him this morning. Yeah. Is Roger, I knew your name. All right. I'll tell you right now, God has faith in you. A lot of people's priesthood, we have faith in God. You hear it all the time. But God has faith in you. Did you hear what I just said? God, you want me to prove it to you? I don't have my Bible, but I got it right here. I don't have it open. It's right here in my hand. Do you know what? When Job, I don't know why I'm doing this. Scripture I have today. When Job, the devil went to God and he said, Job, he said, "Have you not considered me? Have you not considered my servant Job? There is no one like him in all the earth." Did he say that? Who brought the conversation up? Who brought the? Did the devil bring Job up? Did the devil bring Job up? No. God did. He said, "Have you not considered my servant Job?" Guess what? God's telling the devil, guess what? I'll let you do this to him. I'll let you do that to him. I'll let you torment him. I'll let you take everything away from him. He ain't even done nothing to me. But guess what the devil said? When he does, he didn't study this, but I got a Bible in my hand. I'm telling you, God's given it to me. The first thing he took away was the blood sacrifice. The first thing the devil stole from Job was the blood sacrifice. The animals he took was the ones he used to sacrifice to God daily. The first thing the devil wants to do to you is destroy your relationship with God by bringing forth doubt and fear and lack of prayer, lack of Bible reading, a lack of focus on the Lord, and he will tear your spirit down. But he also said, in my flesh, I shall yet see God. Did he not say that? In my flesh. You know what he also said? The things that I have feared have come upon me. Do you know the devil plays on your fear? He plays on your fear. The more you surround yourself with bitterness, fear, and negativity, the more he will feed it. The more you believe you can't do something, the more you're going to believe it and make it possible. Have you ever convinced yourself of something? Come on. And it's not even factual, but you made yourself believe a lie, and you believed it so much it became true to you. I know what I'm talking about because I've had it happen to me. I appreciate this church. I appreciate God the most. Because if you know me about 10 years ago, you never thought I'd be pastoring today. Because I gave up on the ministry. That's right. I quit. I was done. I thought it was too much. I thought it was wrong. I thought it was about me. And I thought, you know what? People don't want me to minister. And you know what? I forgot about what God wanted. But some of you are going through some things and you think instead of a blessing, it is a persecution. But I got a word from God this morning. You need to turn your focus in the other direction. It is not time to run away from God and blame God. It is time you run to Him. It's time you run to Him. It's time you run to Him. It's time you run to Him. Terry, God has been with you. I usually do this, but remember I told you. When I was preaching, I turned to you and I told you, I don't know, do this very often. But I said, God is going to take care of you. And that was before everything I knew was going to happen. I didn't know it, but the Lord knew it. I said, God will take care of whatever you're going to need. She testified last night. God's still taking care of her.
Amen.
Has she had any problems on the way? Has she had some down times? Has she had some times she cried her eyes out? I guarantee she has. But God's got you through it. He saw you through it. She's still sitting here. She's a survivor. Joe, you're a survivor. You're a survivor. The devil tried to take you with your heart. He tried to deal with this on your lungs. He's tried to destroy you many ways. But guess what, Bob? You're a survivor. You are a survivor. You are a survivor. You are a survivor. Because God said you got it. Get your head out of the dirt. Yes, Lord.
Come on.
Shake that dust off.
Yeah.
It's time to shake it off.
Yeah.
You are a child of Almighty God.
Hey.
You are not trash. You are not trash. You are redeemed with the incredible blood of the Lamb. Instead of telling your neighbor about it, tell Jesus.
Amen.
I feel depressed. He's not omniscient. He don't know everything. You know he's not omnipresent, Sister Phyllis. He's not everywhere. No. Cindy, there's no one knows you like Jesus does. Did you hear what I just said? So if the devil's telling you you're worthless, the devil's telling you this, he's telling you are unloved, you don't, no one cares for you, no one tells, no one even asks how you are, no one sees you, no one recognizes you, no one sees the tears you cry at night when no one else is around. Oh, I got news for you. Instead of feeding to him, saying, oh yeah, I know what you're talking about. No, it's time you stand up and say, I know my Redeemer lives. I know my hope, it comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. I look into the hill, which comes my head, but my soul. Praise God. Nobody else excited about that for me, I guess.
Yeah.
But it's easier to feel sorry for ourselves. Yeah. It's easier to feel sorry for ourselves. You know why a lot of times people feel sorry for themselves or want attention from other people? It's because they don't even know their own identity. It's called identity crisis. They have no self-confidence. Why do you think these people, when God made a man a man, and he made a man a man? A woman in trouble. He made a woman, he made a woman. There's no identity, there's no gender crisis. There's no identity crisis. God made you the way you wanted, he wanted you to be. The only reason there's an identity crisis is because you let him walk into your mind, and tell you there's an identity crisis. Because you know why? Because the thing you're looking for is not in that. The thing you're looking for is not in a makeover. The thing you're looking for is not, you're not comfortable with who you are. I got word for you. It's not because God made you wrong. It's because you don't have him. You don't have him living in you. You don't have him living in you. You don't have him living in you. God gave you your life, and he's the one that controls it, and when it's time for it to go, he will be the one that has it taken. A lot of people want to take their life because they think they control it. That's what's wrong. You don't control it. God needs to control you. You're not a mistake. You're not here on my head just because you're here. Schools teach that you're just here because you're here. No. You are here, Carrie, for such a time as this because God ordained you. And thank God he did. He gave me a great hope. And I could not be the man I am, and I could not be a pastor I am, if I didn't have a woman that stood behind me and helped me and prayed for me. It protects my back. She does. I'm telling you, she does. She hears, she knows, God will tell her something, and she'll warn me. She said, you know what? The Lord said this. I said, okay. That's why I learned to listen. Because every time she's told me that, it's become true. God puts people in your life. You have a purpose here, church. Bob, you have a purpose. Stephen, you have a purpose. You're going to be a law police officer. That's a purpose. There's a lot of them. They're not doing it now. They're quitting. Zachary's going to do the same thing. Lord bless you, two men. It's going to be police officers.
Amen.
You know what's funny? She's a sister Faye. I actually was going to be a police officer before God called. I went to school. I didn't complete school. I think I had 20-some credit out of Shawnee. I was going to be a police officer, but God made me meet, he didn't meet me, but thank God he did. He let me meet this wonderful woman, and I had to get a job and get married. And then he called me in the ministry when I was younger. younger child. That is now. It wasn't meant to be bad. I wanted to get a job. I wanted to get a job so I could get married. Harry, that's not funny. But you know what? I'm careful now. I better watch how much food is my food today, huh? Yeah, I keep burping all my clients. So now I'm a burping again. And I have burps myself. But anyway, I want to tell you something. It's 12:05. How do you feel important today? Now, you don't go around strutting like a peacock and think you've got the world lit by your shoulders. Because guess what? Pride will tear you down. But you have to have a little self-pride about yourself. You know what the Bible says about this? A lot of preachers don't preach this anymore, Bob. But you know what it says in Ephesians? You can read it when you get home. It says this, a man that doesn't love his wife don't love his own self. You got to love yourself a little bit before you can love somebody else. Because if you don't love your wife and you don't love the ones around you, guess what? There's really something wrong with you. It's everybody else's fault why I can't be happy. It's everybody else's fault why I'm mad. It's everybody else's fault why I have a bad disposition. It's everybody else's. It's God's fault. It's everybody else's fault I'm bitter and angry. It's everybody else's fault until you realize that it's you. It's you. It's you that needs to change. You will not be free. You will not have freedom. That's what's wrong with our society as our musicians come. That's what's wrong with our society. It's everybody else's fault but mine. Joe, if you go to the prison, most of them say it's somebody else's fault why I'm here. No, it's because you decided to kill someone, or you decided to rob, or you decided to do dope or drugs. It's your own fault. I don't know about you, but I want to be happy. But Brother Claire, do you live in a Candyland world where, no. Come to work with me one day. You think I got a lollipop job. The higher your title is, the more stress you have. In fact, pray for me Tuesday. Because our COO, which has never been to our plant, he's a new one. And Brother Joe, everywhere he's went, someone lost their job. Let me just tell you this. Everybody around our work is walking on needles. And guess what? When you're in a management position, it's even more stressful. Because guess who lost their jobs? It wasn't the hourly employees. It was management people. I tell you right now, I don't live in the Candyland world. I have problems too. But I know my faith. Guess what, Terry? If I decide to be grumpy all the time, I would still have the same problems if I'm happy. And guess what? If I'm happy and I live in Jesus, guess what? I'm going to live longer and be happier. And I'm going to make other people happy and blessed instead of sad and grouchy and hateful and angry. When Jesus hung on that cross, he could have said, I want them all to burn in hell. He said, they're all going to burn in hell what they've done for me. They're going to burn in hell. He didn't say that. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they're doing. We're going to close as they're singing. If someone here said, it's me, O Lord, I'm standing in the need of prayer. I want you to come right now. I don't need to know why you want prayer. I don't care. But you are welcome to come. If you got a physical problem, you got a spiritual problem, you need prayer, I want you to come right now.